Many youngsters in India shy away from politics. Either they say, I don't know, or I'm not interested, which is not an ideal situation that's supposed to be for the future of India. So, however, in order to spread awareness regarding the politics and policy making, Confederation of Indian Industries, a non-profit organization, has organized an event in collaboration with Karnataka Legislation. And the event is named as Ink Parliament, where the students aged between 12 to 14 is going to be participated here. This event aims to empower and encourage the youth of India in meaningful political discourse and governance. The students are engaged in the formation of parties and manifesto development, opening speeches and committee meetings, focusing on pressing issues such as climate change, skilling programs, substance abuse prevention, career choice awareness, legal and civic education. Talking to one of the co-chairperson, Pratik, this is what he had to say. Tell us more about this Young Parliament event.
So, Young Parliament is an initiative by Young Indians, which is a vertical of CII. And under that, we have a vertical called Tharir, where we do upliftment projects and create future leaders for the school children. The aim of Young Indians Parliament is to conduct sessions throughout the country. And we are doing it across 58 chapters. We have 58 chapters in 58 cities of India. And this is the regional round in South, where we have children from South Bangalore and from Kerala who've been participating in this event today. And they will be shortlisted. And the final students will go to the, there are talks that we are going to host the final session in November in the old parliament in Delhi, New Delhi. So the agenda of this is to create future leaders and to instigate, to create a spark for young leaders to come in politics.
Congress leader Rajiv Gowda, MLA Rizwan Arshad inaugurated the event, and with more than 120 students participating in the event from Bengaluru and Kochi, these youngsters conducted a mock parliament session by forming a government, opposition party and assuming different roles that are there in the actual parliament. Reflecting on the event and the current state of the nation, this is what the kids had to say.
Right now, we're forming coalition and talking to other parties about if they want to join us.
Okay, what party are you in?
I'm in the RPP party, RPP, Rashtriya Pragati Party, and this is party one.
Okay, what about you?
Same party, we are just discussing whether we should ally with some parties or not.
What are all the other parties that is there in the...
We have, I don't know all the names exactly, but we have seven parties.
We are finalizing, we are not 100% done yet.
Okay, are you planning for the coalition?
Yes. Want a coalition at the same point. We want to see which parties are good for us and which are not. So we want to move very strategically.
What do you think about India in real scenario?
I feel it's a very diverse, like it is a melting pot of cultures, religions in as a whole, yeah. But it is also a place where you can discover many other cultures other than your own.
Everyone, as one of the House members said, everyone should have an opportunity to speak, because it doesn't really matter whoever you are. It can be from a person who has a job of sweeping floor to a person who's the president of a country or the region. They have the allowance to say, to let the world hear their voice and how they want to cultivate, benefit the region.
What do you think about the real scenario of India?
The real scenario of India, honestly, for me, what I have seen, it's kind of not bad, but not good. Well, it's like, it's based on many cases, like literacy cases, illiteracy cases, digital, like women discrimination, gender discrimination, races. But there are also many schemes that have been put up to reduce these cases, reduce the hierarchy of these cases.
So what do you have?
I feel like India is moving forward, and as he said, the schemes, they are really helping empower women, especially because they are quite discriminated, as I feel. However, I've not personally faced any, but I've seen my friends being discriminated on their color, caste, gender, everything. The littlest of littlest things.
Each one of you should give me one problem that you see in your surroundings or wherever you stay in your life or any national issues?
I think it's a water scarcity most probably. Like a few weeks ago, like in my society or area. No, I'm not. So like we faced a water scarcity problem. Like it was really, I think the government should work on this. The thing is that in all over the world, there are abandoned grounds where they dump garbage. And though there are many awareness programs, campaigns held up, but still there is some cities or everywhere, whenever they see an abandoned ground, they throw garbage there. We have to bring it in.
So air pollution and water pollution is much seen in India. So there is so many solutions. I have searched Tejas Sindal, who is a carbon material industrialist. So he has exhibited one process that many people, like they let out the carbon into rivers and all. So he collects that carbon and makes into tiles. So that is useful.
One of the initiatives.
Yeah.
In India, education is higher. We have government schools, but no one is taking an initiative to study there because they have a particular stereotype in their mind that we don't get a proper facilities over there. So government should improve on that, like improving the government schools.
Corruption, one thing which is prevalent in India is now even in the medicine industry. Famous pharmaceutical companies in the drive of profits ignore the test by the medical authority of India, and the quality is so poor that medicines are now becoming a matter of death than saving lives. And we can see various scams around each pharmaceutical companies, how they're taking as liberals factors just for experimenting medicines, say cancer, before testing. They're tested on few individuals, and the condition has to be seen as worse than any individual which has rights.